Hello everyone, so today we're going to go over section 5.4, surface area of a cylinder. Before we calculate the surface area of a cylinder, we will review some concepts around the circle. So first of all, a circle has a center, which is the point in the middle that's equidistant from the circle itself. Next up, we have the radius, which is the distance from the center of the circle to its edge. And then we have the diameter, which is the distance, which is a line segment connected the edge of the circle, one edge to another that goes through the center of the circle. So this is here a diameter. And finally, we have the circumference, which is the length of the edge around the going around the circle once. So here is the circumference in purple. Okay, so few quick notes here. Sometimes in some textbook, center is spelled with a different spelling. And in terms of labeling diagrams, usually we use the letter C or the letter P for the center of a circle. P just stands for point. Next up, we have the radius, which is usually denoted with the letter R. Diameter is usually labeled with the letter D. And finally, the circumference is usually labeled with a capital C. Next up, we have a couple of familiar formulas. First one is for the circumference of a circle, we have C is equal to pi times D, or 2 times pi times R. And that's because, of course, as you may know, the diameter is equal to 2 times the length of the radius. Likewise for on the other hand, for the area of a circle, we have A equals pi r squared. So it says here, for example 2, if the radius of the above circle is 5 centimeters, we're going to calculate the circumference and the area. Let's go ahead and do that. We have C is equal to 2 times pi times the radius of 5, which is equal to 10 pi. 2 times 5 is 10. Then we can evaluate 10 pi, and if we round to the nearest hundred, we will have 31.42 centimeters. Okay, on the other hand, we have area. A is equal to pi r squared, so we'll substitute 5 for the radius. So 5 squared, of course, is 25, so we have 25 pi. And if you evaluate using a calculator, you'll get 78.54 centimeters squared if you round to the nearest hundredth. Okay. Later on, the answers 10 pi and 25 pi will be preferred in some questions, but for right now, we're going to focus on our decimal answers. So next up, we have the formula for calculating the surface area of a cylinder. Two numbers are going to be used here. We just need to know the radius and the height of the cylinder itself. So as you can see, cylinder has a circle at the top and circle at the bottom. So the first part is to figure out the area of the two circles. Okay, so we'll have A is equal to pi r squared plus pi r squared, which of course is just 2 pi r squared. Okay, once again, this first circle is the top circle, second circle is the bottom circle, and the idea is that they are identical, so we can just add the two areas together and have 2 pi r squared. Step two, now if you unroll the cylinder, you actually get a rectangular side. So the second step is to figure out the area of the side, which is a rectangle. Okay, so since it is a rectangle, we have A equals to length times width. The length of the side would just be equal to the circumference of the circle, so 2 pi r, multiplied by the height of the cylinder, which is the width of the rectangle. And so combined, we'll have 2 pi r h for the second part. So here we have the circumference and h is the height. Okay, so step three, of course, is to add the two together. So the total is going to be surface area equals to 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h, which is the more common formula, although some textbooks do write it as 2 pi r, or factored out, multiplied by r plus h, which also works but is a little bit rarer in terms of being written in books and in notes. Okay, so next we're gonna do some examples with the new formula that we have, 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Okay, so we're gonna estimate the surface area of the cylinder on the left. So usually when we estimate, we just use simpler numbers, so the height is approximately 10, for example, and likewise the diameter is around 6. So then the radius would have been 3.1 centimeters, which is approximately 3 centimeters. So we're going to write that into our formula. So surface area is equal to 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Okay, so substitute in the radius of 3 and the height of 10. Again, these are estimated radius and height. So the first part, 3 times 3, is of course 9, 9 times 2 is 18, so first term will be 18 pi, and the second term will be 60 pi, so altogether that is 78 pi. So at this point, you can either use 3 as a approximation of pi, or you can multiply by 3.14. Either way, you'll get a number that's approximately 245, somewhere around there. So that will be an estimate of the surface area of a cylinder. Now, this will be an underestimate because for both the height and the radius, we rounded down. Okay, so let's use the same formula to calculate the surface area now. So that will be 2 pi and then 3.1 squared this time, plus 2 pi multiplied by 3.1, the actual radius, and then the height of 11. So if you're going to use a calculator to evaluate this, you can actually put it all together in one go, and you'll get 274.64 if you round to the nearest hundredth of a square centimeter. Again, we knew beforehand that the estimate was an underestimate, and the calculation shows that that was true. Just one more. Again, same thing, just another application of the formula. So surface area is equal to 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Substitute in the radius. In this case, we're given the radius directly, so that's just 4.8 squared plus 2 pi and then 4.8. Once again, the radius multiplied by the height, which is 2.1. So, once that's evaluated, again rounding to the nearest hundredth, you'll get 208.1 centimeters squared. Okay, just the one formula today, 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h, and that is for the surface area of a cylinder. That's it for today. Thank you for listening.